Let's start with some fun facts. So I'm showing here a cartoon of the Mariana Trench. And Mariana Trench, as some of you might know, it's the deepest trench on the planet. And it's really deep. So if you look at the how deep it is, this Mariana Trench is approximately 2,550 kilometers deep. So that's really, really deep. If you look at how wide it is, it kind of varies from the top to the bottom, but on an average, this Mariana Trench has a width of 70 kilometers. So if I look at the aspect ratio and I define the aspect ratio as my height divided by my width, so for my Mariana Trench, it has an aspect ratio of this 2,550 kilometers divided by 70 kilometers, which is the aspect ratio of approximately 37. I've already worked it out for you. So this Mariana Trench has an aspect ratio of 37, and it's so deep that there have been only two human exploration down the Mariana Trench. And more recently, it was in news because David Cameron, who's a very famous film producer, he wanted to go down there and really check out what's in there. Didn't really find anything new, but anyway, it was in news recently because of that. On the other hand, on this other side, what I'm showing is the tallest skyscraper in the world, which is Burj Khalifa in Dubai. And this Burj Khalifa has a height of 828 meters. So it's the tallest building on the planet, and it has a width of around 175 meters on the bottom. In the middle, or on the average, it has a width of let's say around 100 meters. So if I look at the aspect ratio for my Burj Khalifa, this has an aspect ratio of 828 meters divided by 100 meters, or around 8.2. So the another interesting fact about Burj Khalifa is that it costed around 1.5 billion US dollars to make. And to put that in perspective, with semiconductor technology, a semiconductor state-of-the-art fab today costs $7 billion to make. So one semiconductor fab is more than four Burj Khalifas that you can make. So that sometimes makes you wonder why anybody with some sane mind would spend this much amount of money to make a semiconductor fab. But nonetheless, the point I want to bring home is that the tallest building in the world has an aspect ratio of 8.2. The deepest trench in the world has aspect ratio of 37. And I want to put these numbers I want to put these numbers in perspective, because increasingly we are seeing similar deep trenches and skyscrapers in semiconductor technology. So why is that? So let's look at this stacked capacitor DRAM, which is you'll find it in all of your iPhones and your iPads. The DRAM essentially uses this stacked capacitor technology. And if you shown here is a SEM picture of your DRAM chip. So if you take a SEM picture of your DRAM array, it looks like these skyscrapers, or it looks like these stacked capacitors, which are essentially very tall, and they remind you of these tall buildings that you see in any American city downtown. Reminds me of the Manhattan downtown. And there's somewhere a capacitor over here, which is used to access and reach. There's somewhere a transistor over here, which is used to access and read this capacitor. But the point I want to make is it's increasingly looking like those skyscrapers. And So why does this stack capacitor has to be so tall? So that brings me to this the way this one transistor, one capacitor DRAM works is that you have charge stored on your stacked capacitor, and when you access it using this word line, when you turn this transistor on, that that charges up your bit line, and that increases the voltage on your bit line, and you detect that increase in voltage using a sense amplifier. So the amount this bit line voltage goes up can be described by this simple formula, where you are amount the threshold, the voltage by this bit line voltage will go up would be proportional to your overall operating voltage. Let's fix it at 1 volt, and then it's just a capacitance divider. So it's depends on the how large your bit line capacitance this capacitor, which is your DRAM capacitor, has to drive up. So a typical number to at least sense this increase in voltage, your sense amplifier needs a voltage increase of at least 150 millivolts, and this bit line capacitance is somewhere in the order of 100 femtofarad. So if you put that number in here, what you get is your capacitor has to be at least has to have a capacitance of more than 15 femtofarad, and femtofarad is 10 to power minus 15 farad. So you think that you might be thinking that this is a very low number, but in fact, to achieve this number at these very low geometries, you need to make a very tall structure. So this is another view of this same stack capacitor, but this is showing a 1D array of these capacitor cells, and to essentially achieve that capacitance of 15 femtofarad, the diameter of this stack capacitor is essentially driven by the dictum of Moore's law, that you want to pack them as closely as possible. So this diameter can in current day technology is around 30 nanometer, or the width of this structure is around 30 nanometer, and to essentially achieve this capacitance, which is proportional to the area, so this capacitance would be proportional to your perimeter of this thing hanging up in the sky, which would be essentially proportional to the diameter and proportional to the height. So the diameter is essentially currently 30 nanometer, and it's projected to go even down. So to achieve this 15 femtofarad capacitance, the height that you require on these things has come out to actually become somewhere around 2000 nanometer. And if you again come back to our aspect ratio, which we in this case can be defined as our height divided by this diameter. So as you can see in this case, it's 2000 of nanometer or 2 micron divided by 30 nanometer, which gives you an aspect ratio of this would be somewhere around 66. So you can already see that this stack capacitor, the capacitor in this stack capacitor DRAM, has an aspect ratio of 66, which is higher than what you get in your Mariana Trench, and much higher than what you get in your Burj Khalifa. Let's look at another chip where again you see this high aspect ratio come into play, and in this case I want to look at an example where you have a deep trench. So looking at the NAND flash memory chip, so all our iPad and our iPhone have these flash memory chip. So if you open it up and take a close look at it, it looks something like this. So you have shown here are these this cross section along my word lines. So I have these different transist, these different flash memory cells along a word line. And what I'm seeing here is essentially again these deep trenches formed in my STI edge. So again, the Moore's, the dictum of Moore's law requires that I pack as many of these flash memory cells in a given area, and it requires me to bring these different cells as close to each other, which requires which puts a really stringent requirement on the distance I can have between my STI and you know, current or technology, current technology, this distance is between 20 to 30 nanometer. And on the other hand, we discussed about flash memory. So we saw that, you know, you really need to, you apply very high voltages. You apply voltages of 20 volts to program and erase these cells. So you need a very good isolations between these two cells. So which requires you to have a very deep, dig a very deep trench so you can isolate the voltage between these two adjacent cells. So these STI, if you look at the dimensions over here, so this STI has is 217 nanometer deep in this case, and I just describe you that the it's between 20 to 30 nanometer wide. So again, if I look at the aspect ratio over here, it's 217 divided by 20. So again, an aspect ratio of 10, that is an aspect ratio of greater than that of the Burj Khalifa. So similar story repeating again when you have when you make a FinFET device. Again, you need a STI edge, and shown here is this FinFET from TSMC from IDM 2010. So again, you see that, you know, you need to define this fin. You again get aspect ratios which can be anywhere between 5 to 10. Even a bigger aspect ratio, something we'll touch upon when we talk about packaging. So when we'll talk about this through silicon via technology that is used to connect, stack up these different chips, say let's say you have a DRAM or a microprocessor chip, so stack them on top of each other. And these are, this is achieved by this electrical contact, which is a through silicon via. And again, these etches are anywhere between 100 to 200 micron deep, and you require them to be 5 to 10 micron wide. So again, an aspect ratio of anywhere between 20 or even higher. So what we are seeing is that, you know, increasingly we are seeing in our semiconductor technology these high aspect ratio structure, and this causes a lot of process challenges. How to etch these structure, how to fill these structures without creating a pinch off or air gap, how to prevent them from collapsing or falling on top of each other. And these are, you know, increasingly becoming very challenging issues in semiconductor technology.